Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Isra mentioned the ayah that means, do not give a judgment about a religious matter without knowledge. For one's ears and eyes and heart will be questioned on the day of a judgment. It was narrated that once the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was asked about the best places on earth and the worst places on earth, to which he replied, I don't know. I will ask my brother Jibreel. He asked Angel Jibreel alayhi salam. Jibreel alayhi salam, Angel Jibreel said, I don't know. Then he came back to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam with the answer that the best places are the mosques and the worst places are the marketplaces. Also Imam Ali radiallahu anhu said once, how soothing it is on my heart to say I don't know when I'm asked about something to which I have no answer. If Imam Ali, the most knowledgeable of this nation, after Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, did not dare to give a judgment without knowledge, how dare some people these days who haven't acquired 1/10 of the knowledge of those scholars, if they ask about something about religion, they rush and they give the judgment. They destroy themselves and they destroy others. They go astray and they lead others astray as well. For that reason, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam warned us against issuing a judgment without knowledge. And he said that whoever issues a judgment without knowledge, then he is cursed by the angels of the skies and earth. This is to show the severity of such an act, to give a judgment without knowledge. Always stop on your limits. Do not cross the borders, your limits. You know yourself. If you ask about something pertaining your religion and you have no answer to it, do not say from your own. Do not give your opinion. It's not a guessing game. It's religion. If everyone can give his own opinion about religion, our religion would have been lost. But alhamdulillah azza wa jal, we have something called Isnad. And there is no such a thing in the previous nations. Like when I hear something from my shaykh, he heard it from his shaykh, his shaykh heard it from his shaykh, and so on, with a continuous chain of narrations, until one reaches the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. This is how our beautiful religion has been preserved. Otherwise, if anyone can say whatever he wants, whenever he wants, then our religion will be lost. That's why you hear sometimes on some TV stations, some people might give fatwa that contradicts the Quran, the Hadith, the scholarly consensus, what the scholars said before, because he's looking for fame. He wants to come up with something strange, different from others, but unfortunately, by opposing the religion. Just because people glorify him, people honor him, they look at him as Shaykh or Mufti or the like, he thinks he has attained a level where he can say whatever he wants, whenever he wants, wal-iyazu billah. So be cautious. Do not spread anything unless you are 100% sure it is true. If you receive any message on WhatsApp or any social network, do not rush by spreading it to your friends before checking if this information is correct or not. Like some people now, they spread a hadith that is fabricated about the Prophet and it is against the religion. They say in it that the Prophet said, whoever give the news about the beginning of Ramadan will be saved from hellfire. And before that, they used to say that the Prophet said, whoever gives the news about the beginning of Sha'ban will be saved from hellfire. And before it they said, whoever gives the news about the beginning of Rajab will be saved from hellfire. All these ahadith are fabricated, and it is against the foundations, the fundamentals of our belief. Because it's not simply for one to say to someone else, Ramadan started, that means now he is saved from hellfire, he won't be tortured. This has never been mentioned in the Quran, nor in the Hadith, nor by any of the scholars of Islam. So be cautious, do not spread any information unless you are 100% sure it is correct, it is taken from trustworthy people. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from going astray. We ask Allah azza wa jal to keep us steadfast on the path of Islam and end our life as righteous Muslims. Ameen, and Allah knows best.